Hello. Maybe a little bit more light. This will probably be another lab meditation to listen in on. I'm going to step outside in a moment, but just work on the side of the street here. And it's in New York City, so we can perhaps expect that this will be a brief meditation, and also expect that it maybe hard to hear, could be interrupted. So, boatload of apologies in advance. But I just got off the highway, sort of the first spot where I thought I could kind of pull over for a moment without having somebody behind me or trying to pass me or me needing to follow the directions. So there's you might be able to see, but there's kind of the supports for an elevated road. And in fact, we have another one here. Might be, this will be a little harder to see, but if you follow that car that's driving and see the headlights coming, they're going right underneath the arch
span. And there's the moon and a plane passing by, and some building apparently, the science center. I think that's the science center. Some old architecture,
give you a sense as usual where we are. And the George Washington Bridge is just over that way, not quite in view. I was hoping I'd be able to stop a little bit earlier so we can do a little meditation around the bridge. I got to drive under the the span that gets to the span, I guess. Yeah, this is massive, massive footings. Just thinking about the bridges. Now here I am, the way it worked out, I'm between these two elevated spans here. So I'm kind of still thinking about footings. Actually, a little bit cold. So I was kind of thinking that, in order to have a bridge, you kind of need a strong footing, at least one. More often, two or more. And I was thinking how, very often your mind leaves the present moment. Jumps ahead to, based on expectation, anxiety, concern, consideration, planning. And the body, of course, remains here. The body remains right where you are right now. So kind of thinking how the body is kind of set into now as a footing, and the mind may leave the now, it may take the span bridge to another moment, another now, that the body will arrive in its own time. So I kind of thought that a nice meditation might be to notice when the mind leaves the space of the body, the now moment, and think of it as a bridge. Think of the ability that the footing of the body's presence in the now, the ability that it gives to the mind to loft itself to another place. Even though a big part of a meditation student's thoughts might be, it shouldn't loft, it shouldn't go anywhere, it's supposed to be in control, we could instead consider that the footing of the now, the self, resting in the present, allows for the mind to do what it can do. And so, in a simple Zen meditation, stilling the body, recognizing it like a footing, connected to some bedrock of stillness or quiet or love. And from there, recognizing that the mind leaving the body is made possible by the fact of the body, the way that the body exists in time. And so we could, you know, we could simply share the blame with the body, that the meditation is sort of uncontrolled and the mind has left the present moment. We could do that. But we can also just notice the interrelationship between the two. And so, for me, I'm going to just try and do that. I'm not going to last too much longer out here. Maybe I'll turn so you can have the moon in view. So even just in that short amount of time, I can notice that every erroneous movement of my mind away from the place of the body, away from the meditation, is it really evidence of a collaboration between